Although a great empire, the Incas lacked a written record of their history, but they did leave us a myriad of awesome myths and legends, including the strange depictions at Nazca. Could the waving man at Nazca, for example, be an actual representation of a deity emerging from a portal or a stargate? This piece of ancient art shows signs that it may be somehow relating to the Sumerian Abzu. The Abzu, which is often spoken of in Sumerian text, and literally means distant water, ab meaning water, and zu translates far, distant, or deep. Many experts have deciphered this as place that originates groundwater, fresh water that maintains life with the use of irrigation. But is this the true meaning of the Abzu? In a hymn to Elil, the text reads, "The Abzu, which no one can understand, its interior is a distant sea, which heaven edge cannot comprehend." In the curse of Agad, the text reads, "Abzu, where the fates are determined." In Sumerian texts, the Abzu is always preceded by the article the, which lends the belief that the Abzu is a state of being or state of mind. As an example, one might say they are going to New York, a specific location, or they may say they are planning to go to the city, which implies a state of being, as in shopping, nightlife, or dining out. In the Sumerian text relating Inanna, Enki's daughter, and Enki, Inanna speaks, "I shall direct my steps to Enki, to the Abzu, to Eridu, and I myself shall speak coaxingly to him in the Abzu in Eridu." Directed her steps all by herself towards Enki's Abzu in Eridu. Enki, the king of the Abzu, the Lord Enki, looked up at the Abzu. It becomes apparent that the Abzu is something that is a lot more than a simple source of underground water. We know that from these texts that Enki is the source of the Abzu, and it is located in his city of Eridu. Enki is also recorded in these texts to have to look up to see the Abzu. To have to look up in a land that is extremely flat must mean that Enki is looking up to the top of the highest building in Eridu, which would be the temple ziggurat. This is confirmed by a fragmented text on the heron and turtle, which reads, "Then on the ziggurat, King Enki was on the ziggurat, the great brickwork of the ziggurat, the Abzu, the brickwork of the Abzu." Once in the Abzu, they totally immerse themselves in its water. Without the Abzu, the great gods would simply have grown old like the rest of mankind and eventually died. They had to continually enter the Abzu and immerse themselves in its water in order to extend their lives. This is the state of being that is referred to as entering the Abzu, a state of rejuvenation, an exhilarating moment where water itself can be controlled and where one seems to levitate inside the Abzu. It just seems to us somehow that these things are related, and maybe the waving guy of Nazca is going to the Abzu. He is facing the water, which has led to some to theorize he may be signaling the fishing trade, but nonetheless to do with water and perhaps a portal of sorts, and maybe clues to this connection can be further explored in Peru at the site of the Devil's Doorway. Within the Heyumarca mountain region of Peru, there have been found a mysterious structure close to Lake Titicaca. It had only recently been found, in 1996 in fact, and though local people already knew of its existence, it didn't become widely acknowledged to much more recently. It looks like a carved rock measuring 7 meters high and 7 meters wide. At the center, there is a 1.5 meters wide niche, which gives the impression of a door. As told by local legend, many structures, including Tiwanaku and this structure, which is known as the Portal to the Gods, or the Portal to Heaven, were erected by Lord Muru, a ruler who came from the land of Mu, an ancient sunken continent which was once situated in the Pacific Ocean. It's called the Devil's Door by the locals because some have claimed that people have disappeared, and in some cases, reappeared near the door. Some have noted strange tall men accompanied by glowing balls of lights walking through the doorway. The Midas Monument in Turkey is another example of this type of mystical and interdimensional gateway existing, with stories capturing the imagination for ages. Even to this day, if you have the magic touch, some would say you have the Midas touch. And this is because the 19th century Scottish archaeologist William M. Ramsay, who visited the area and called the monument Midas City, he associated the Yazilikaya with the Phrygian King Midas due to the inscription engraved in the rock bearing the name of that monarch. Known as the Midas Monument, it's a beautifully decorated facade carved into the vertical rock, dating back to the 7th century BC. Its appearance resembles an entrance to a temple, but actually only a very shallow niche is carved into the rock. Most popularly, it's used to house a statue of the goddess Cybele, also known among the Phrygians as Matar, and its similarities with that of the Devil's Doorway thousands of miles away in Peru are shocking. The facade has a square shape with a side length of 16 meters. It is an imitation of the Phrygian Megaron, a rectangular structure with a large, deep hall fronted by a much shallower anteroom or porch. The niche carved into the rock is surrounded by geometric patterns, invoking the maze. The whole structure was topped was an akrotirion, but unfortunately it has not been preserved to our times. Above there is also an inscription in Old Phrygian carved into the rock. It states that a certain Attis, perhaps a priest, dedicated this monument to King Midas, because Phrygia was ruled by several kings bearing this name. The researchers are not able to clearly identify the monarch who was honored by this monument. Could the cultures be connected? Are these ancient representations of some sort of power source? Physical passageways hold the potential for wormhole or stargate capabilities. Perhaps in the ancient times, they were very active, but as we said before, only the stone material will survive in the shadows of time. What are you guys thinking about this anyway? Are we onto something with the doorway connections? What do you guys think is going on? Comments below, and as always, thank you for watching.